people have granite in their homes, granite countertops. This house is filled with granite. I'm going to take you through some of the rooms. The bathroom's full of it. It's a very common thing used in a lot of modern homes. And what some people don't realize, and there is a fear going around, though for those who do realize it, is that sometimes granite has naturally occurring radiation in it. It just sometimes happens. It's part of nature. Things are organic. There's different kinds. So some people have radioactive countertops and don't realize it. Is it really a concern? Is it a lot? Is it that much that you should really be worried about it? Well, that's what this video is about. If you go out in the sun, you're getting radiation. There's natural amounts of radiation in everything. When we just walk around, if you stand next to a microwave, you're getting a lot of radiation. But just going around in nature, you know, even where you walk out in nature, there's granite in the ground that could have some, you know, radon coming out of the ground. There's all kinds of radiation. There's different kinds. The common kind that people measure is sieverts. That's what this testing device is. I bought a testing device and we're going to go through my house. We're going to see how radioactive my granite in this house is. You can get these things online, you know, Amazon. This one is by a company called Radex. It's a German company. Yay, Germans. I trust the Germans. They're very good at making very high precision devices. So this one is really, really cool. And it's so simple to operate. All you do is push the button and it starts. There's a square on there, and when the square blinks, every time it blinks, a radioactive particle has hit the sensor and it blinks. The more it blinks, the more radioactive particles are hitting this device. It takes four readings, and then it takes the average, and then it gives you the total of the average. So I'm gonna start this right now. There it goes. And I'm gonna lay it down, and it's gonna start taking its reading. There's different kinds of radiation. This one measures in millisieverts and microsieverts. 0.1 is very low and doesn't get any lower than that. 0.21 is pretty normal, depends on the average geology. 0.42 happens occasionally with no reason, just keep an eye on it. 0.83, that's when you need to start worrying. No need to panic though, but try to figure out what's going on. 1.25, that's when the risk factor starts coming in. 0.4 is when the real risk factor of cancer is, if you're on this all the time. 20,000 is nuclear plant workers, and 100,000 is if you're working in Fukushima. You just wait a minute or two. You mean you want the most accurate reading possible, so the longer you wait, the more accurate the reading becomes. So it's 0.18. 0.21 is normal. So it's actually below normal. This countertop is below normal. It just went up to 0.22. It varies because there's radioactive particles, they bounce through the air. So come here, look at it again. Here you can see it. See, it says 0.22, and then right here it says 0.21, which is pretty much the same thing, is pretty normal. Depends on local geology. So this is fine. This is totally acceptable. So, and notice how big this countertop is. This kitchen has a lot of granite. There's granite there, there's granite over here. And you can tell this all came from the same quarry. Different kinds of granite come from different areas. Different parts of the country have different levels of radiation. Then there's some that come from China or wherever. You know, there's granite comes from everywhere. So you can't say that all granite's the same. Each batch is different. So let's go to the bathroom upstairs. Let's check that one out. There's granite everywhere. As you can see, there's granite here that goes up. There's granite all kinds of places. As you can see in here, this whole place is nothing but granite. The floor, the walls, the ceiling, it's granite everywhere. So I guess this is about as granite-y as it gets. So let's try this out here. So this is a serious concentration of granite. So whatever's in the rock, it's going to be more concentrated here than anywhere else. So as you can see, this one is about 0.27. It's a little bit more than downstairs, but it's still totally safe, still totally normal. This is a normal amount found in when you're walking around out in nature. This is not counting sunlight. This is just, you know, coming out of the stone and stuff. But there's extra. If you were to walk let's say you're hiking on a mountain and suddenly there's the granite, the mountain's made out of granite or whatever. There's radiation coming out of the mountain and the rock, but then you've got the sunlight too, and the sunlight, that's radiation. So you're getting, this is we're inside, so there's no sunlight, so we're fine with that. But like I said, a healthy body can handle normal amounts of radiation. Heavy metals can be cleared out of the body, no problem, if the body's functioning properly. This is not something to be worried about, but there are situations where there is granite quarried from more radioactive areas. So that's what these things are good for testing for. So we went to the local granite countertop place to take measurements and see what's out there. These stone pieces are from all over the world, and it's amazing how different the readings are. Most of them were pretty safe, but a few of them were pretty high. Some of them were 0.9 and 1, a pretty darn high reading. I would not want this countertop in my house. There was one that was like 0.6, 0.7, but on the average, most of them were safe enough to have in a house. So that was interesting. For fun, I took my handy little radiation tester to the Atomic Testing Museum, thinking they had all kinds of radioactive artifacts, but they didn't. I think they were ready for people like me, and they were playing it really safe. Even the little sample they had for radioactive rock was barely even registering. So I had to take matters into my own hands and order my own sample.
Okay, here I have some uranium ore. Where can you get uranium? Pretty much where any other American can get anything. On eBay. Alright, so here we go. Let's see what uranium ore tests like, shall we? So that was interesting. If you're a scientist or a chemist and you like playing with this kind of stuff, leave a comment below and I'll send you the sample for free. If you live in America, I don't need it anymore. Just wanted to make this experiment. So this uranium had a reading of 4.5, and some of the granite countertops had a reading of 1, like 0.91, which is pretty high for a granite countertop. It depends where they come from. They come from all over the world, quarries all over the world. It's naturally occurring radiation that's embedded in the rock. Some of them have almost nothing, some of them have more. So it helps if you have gonna have a lot of granite in your house to get a little tester. They're not much. This one's by Radex. I'll put the link below. But it's, you know, again, it's how much exposure you get. If you're there all day long hovering over the stuff, that's different than if you just come in and you're there for a minute and then you leave. If you walk around in nature, out in the desert, there's natural uranium outcroppings. There's uranium mines and things where it's all over the place. So it does occur naturally. It depends if you're sleeping on it or if you're just walking by it. Big difference.
So if you do get a high reading from a countertop or something that, you know, is in your house, several things to think about. One is, how much are you really there all the time? If you're only there like a few minutes a day, no big deal. If you're there a lot, then several options. One is get rid of the countertop, unfortunately. But most people don't have really bad radiation from a countertop. It's just not that much. So it's probably not a problem for most people. And the other thing is, like I said, eat right, be healthy, cleanse your body, because the more you detox your body, the best thing to get rid of, because there's people in Hiroshima who are still alive or have been alive until recently, you know, who lasted another 60 years after the explosion, who are right near where the bomb went off. The reason they survived so long is because they were eating a lot of seaweed. And the seaweed was radioactive too. So how could that be? Because people get all worried about, you know, seaweed and the ocean and the sea moss and stuff like that. Seaweed has something called algin, which binds heavy metals and takes it out of the body. So even though it might even be slightly radioactive, it doesn't put radiation into your body, it takes it out of your body. It's a binder, it takes it out, it carries it through, it does not allow it to release. So seaweed's an amazing stuff. Seaweed is the best thing you can do if you have radiation exposure or radiation in your body or heavy metals. Seaweed. Anyway, so that's my little curiosity thing for the day. This is, a device, I'll put the link down below, by a German company, that it's a little handy pocket device that you can measure radiation with. And that's our little thing for today. little whatever health thing.